And here in part 2, we'll be looking at the actual G-Falcon unit itself. So, first off, I want to say, not a big fan of the red. This is back when they were using the brighter red, which looks more toy-like. I guess it's okay, but I don't really like it, because it doesn't give it more of a toyish feel. And just a little too... It's kind of see-through in the light, to an extent. I don't know, I just don't really like it. But I do like the design of the G-Falcon, the way it looks. It's neat, it's different. Got the beam cannons here. You got missile pods that open up. It's all one solid piece, but I like the fact that you can actually open up the doors. Fuel tanks, I would assume. Thrusters back here. Sticker-wise, you got the cockpit. This metallic red on the nose cone. Some gold on the vents, also on the cannons, both sides. Gray on the body, and then these little winglets have two stickers of gray, and this one has one. And that's it for the stickers. Got some molded in Vulcans on the front. Now, the connection of this little cockpit to the body isn't the best. It's very easy to come off. But the cool thing is, this thing's actually its own little fighter. So you can move that up and extend the where the thruster is in here. And so now it can fly under its own power, which it does when it's connected to like either the Leopard Destroy or the when the main body is connected to the Leopard Destroy or the Air Master Burst. This is its own little fighter. And it does have nice detail on it. Yeah, I like the fact that it has two-tone blue. That is different. So, by itself, it's okay. No way to actually, like, have it flat on its surface, really. And there's no way to really... I guess you could try and connect that part to an action base. It might work. I don't know. These cannons do rotate up and down. These fins are hinged. Fuel tanks can move, mostly, and they have molded hydraulics, but it's for like the combinations, which we might as well get to right now. So, the double X, the high grade double X that it comes with. Might as well do, we'll do the, it's, I guess you'd call it, mobile armor mode, like plane mode. So you basically just keep it all straight, rotate the panels to the back, and then the cannons go straight ahead. And I mentioned these are floppy. This is going to be a big problem, unfortunately. And I can't figure out a way without modifying the kit to change that. Now I'm also going to remove this panel on the backpack. And actually we'll do that later. So we got some hinges to open up the doors here. Now, there's two sets of bars, and I always wondered back in the day when I first got the separate leads what these holes are for. They're connected to the Falcon. Use the ones that are longer at the back. Now, I'm going to try and do this on camera, but it's going to be tricky. So, let's see if I can do it. Okay, there's one. And there is the second one. Okay. So that's connected, and now what we're going to do is use this peg here, and it's going to go into the backpack. So that will make the body of the double X nice and secure to the G-Falcon, which is good. Now, you can take the nose cone, and it's gonna, these grooves in the red are gonna go between the shoulder armor and the torso of the double X. Like that. Now, this would actually work pretty well if these cannons would actually hold up. Oops. Try that again. There we go. See, they're supposed to go straight ahead. And that in itself, I think, looks pretty cool. So you'd have the cannons facing forward, you'd have the beam cannons on the sides, missile pods. But, I don't know, maybe other people have tighter joints on their kits. I switched out the polycaps and did nothing. The hinges are just too loose. I could probably modify it, but right out of the box, that's all I get. I don't see anybody to lock them in place. They don't seem to connect anything on the G-Falcon. It's kind of disappointing because I really do like it. However, I did find the other combination with the Airmaster Burst is more secure. At least the one time I did it. So let's get rid of you for now. And we'll bring in the Airmaster Burst. So, this guy, you have to have the wings, which are usually out, like that. You want to keep them in mobile suit mode. We also want to keep the little winglets out. And he also has holes on his legs, and they're going to go into the other set of pegs. So we got to put these back and pull these out. Because the Airmaster Burst is going to be farther forward, so these ones will make more sense. And because they are farther forward, it's a little easier to peg them in. Did I get that one? I'll say it. I got it. Close that up. Now, to connect the front of the body, underneath this blue part, there is a flip-out peg, which I've already flipped out, and it's going to go into where the nose cone used to be for the G-Falcon. Peg right into there. Good. Sorry, get as far in as you can. And there is the Airmaster Burst with the G-Falcon, and that actually looks really good, and it's, like I said, it's pretty solid. It holds together fairly well. I don't mind painting one or the other, like, to match each other, like painting this one light blue or that one dark blue. They look pretty decent. And a longer mobile armor. I like it. This is definitely my favorite, I think, out of all the combinations. But there are more things that can be done. So we'll just get rid of this. Oops. I guess I took out the, well, they're just polycapped in. It doesn't really matter. Go right back in. So, we're gonna do the combination with the XX in mobile suit mode. Okay, so I've got the XX ready with the cannons out and the satellite panels. Now, we still want that panel removed, but we also want the one down here, which would attach the weapons rack for the separate release. And now to get the G-Falcon ready, bring these fuel tanks down like that, and also bring this red connector out and flip this forward, and we're pretty much ready to go. Now we'll take the nose cone again and collapse it. And it's going to go... Wait, I gotta collapse the thruster. It's going to... Hey, the same grooves are going to go into the torso, or around the torso, but facing forward this time. To give us some chest armors. And this one likes to unpeg. Anyway, so now we have that. And now, we're going to connect the blue peg into the backpack, and the red one into the back skirt. So I find it's easier to do the back skirt first, and then just angle it and connect both together, like that. There we go. And now you just have to lower these parts and pray to God Gundam that the tripod parts don't collapse. Because they don't click into place. I wish they did, because that would make this a lot easier to stand. But as it is, That is the combination, which you see the most in the series. So, it's okay, like I said, as long as these fuel tanks don't fall over, you're good to go. But it takes up, this is like 3 mobile suit, maybe even 4 mobile suit wide, or deep, on a shelf. Like, it's staying by itself, unless you can fit maybe a small one underneath, right here. But it does look cool, I like it. Now, there is the last combination with the Leopard Destroyer, which I couldn't find mine. And I just realized his cheek piece came off again. Definitely gonna have to glue these. But the Leopard Destroyer, I couldn't find him. Because he's one I built years ago, like, before I started doing reviews. So, I can show it with the double X here. I'm gonna take off the panels. And the cannon. Just to show it'll be easier. Alright, so. I believe it's, I don't know if it uses a connection down here. I don't know if it uses the one up here. It might. I don't know if it has one on the Leopard Destroyer. But what we're going to do is you can actually unpeg the light blue from the dark blue. And then you're supposed to flip it all the way around so that the light blue part is facing like straight up, and then rotate the cannons forward. Bring that down, bring this forward. I'd say the best way is to keep these, they look like hydraulics, keeps them all the way up. It kind of keeps the chunky part like from flopping. So like that. And then once I make sure these are down for support, the fuel tanks, and then you just peg it in. Yeah, I don't, yeah, that would not work. The red part would not work. It's not, it can't go, like, it goes up too far and then you can only connect to the bottom. So maybe it is the bottom. I don't think so. I would assume it's the top. But that is how it connects to the Leopard Destroyer. So you have the missile pods here, and you got the cannons all facing forward. I'm not sure if it would hit the Leopard Destroyer like it would the double X here. But I mean, that's how it would work, because the Leopard is all about range. So this just gives them more firepower. But it's definitely a little fiddly, at least on the double X. But it's a different configuration, and it definitely does change. It does compact the whole depth of the toy model. So that's one good thing, I guess. And I do want to mention, before I forget, if you have the Master Grade Bandai version or the Master Grade Bandai version, you can connect this into that. Let me bring up the Bandai one, because the model has a panel covering a port here and also down here. Now, to connect it to the Bandai here, I had to remove the panel because I couldn't, it just wouldn't, the panel couldn't go up high enough in order to clear that port, so it would actually be usable. But with this, let me actually show it off, might as well. It's a little tight. All tight quarters, but it will peg into the bottom. It's a little awkward. I've done it before. Alright, so it's a little fiddly, but it does connect. It takes a little bit of time. He lost his arm. And you can get the chest piece on. Oh, so yeah, you can do it. It might be easier on the Bandai version, I don't know, but it can be done. So yeah, if you have the Master Grade, you can attach this if you'd rather do that. So that is the XX G-Falcon set. It's okay. I still think the XX is a pretty good kit by itself. The G-Falcon is, I mean, let's face it, what other mobile armor do we have that can connect to a Gundam and actually be well 100 scale? Like, I don't count the Deep Striker, because the Deep Striker is, you just, its parts grafted onto the S Gundam, which it can't separate from by, like, actually function as a separate mobile suit. This one can. And it's a like all the forms it has are like some of them are okay. This one with the double X and like fighter mode, unless you can figure out how to get the cannons to stay straight up, doesn't work. The robot mode configuration is okay. The one with the leopard destroyer, I assume, is okay. It looks kind of cool. But my favorite is definitely with the Air Master Burst. It seems to be the most solid with all the three connection points. And I think it looks the best. So, it's okay. I wouldn't go out of my way to find it. But if you do find it at retail, you might want to pick it up. So, that's about it. And I'll see you in the next review.